Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. In this chapter, we are going to learn ratio decidendi, orbital recta and doctrine of stare decisis. This is very important for CS executive new syllabus. So what is ratio decidendi? You can write only these 5 points because in exam you have to write, remember these points very quickly. So I have made only these 5 points. You can write in directly in this exam. Ratio decidendi is a principle of law made by the judge to decide the problem. Who made this? Ratio decidendi is a principle of law made by the judge to decide the problem. Second, ratio decidendi means the reason of the decisions which binds parties and also forms as law to the future generation. Third, ratio decidendi are bindings. These are bindings. Fourth, judicial principle which is general in the operation, in the operates as a precedent and has the force of law. This general principle applies in the particular decision is known as ratio decidendi of a case. Fifth, for the purpose of application of ratio decidendi, the facts of the two cases, previous and present, must be identical, material and relevant. For the purpose of application of ratio decidendi, the facts of the two cases, previous and present, must be identical, material and relevant. That is, if there is any case previously decided and now it is going to be decided on the same facts, it should be identical, material and relevant. Ratio decidendi is not applicable in the subsequent case. It is called distinguishing the case. Now obiter dicta. Obiter dicta are observations made by the judge which are not essential for reaching the decision. These are only the observations, okay? So second point you can write, obiter dicta means dictum given by the way and are binding only on the parties and do not amount to law and hence not binding on future generation. Third point, obiter dicta has no binding force. Fourth point, obiter dicta is what the judge said unwantedly, that is just by way. Fifth, the defects in the legal system can be pointed out in these obiter dicta. Sixth, judges often express legal opinion on issues they are not asked decide. These statement of law are not necessary for the decision. They give and go beyond the requirement of the particular case. Such dicta are therefore called obiter dicta. These dictum are of no binding force. They do not make rules. Now, doctrine of stare decisis. It means that where a rule has once become a settled law, it is to be followed. Although some inconvenience may grow from a strict observation of the same. It means following up of decision. Two conditions. There must exist reliable reports of the case. Second, there must also be settled judicial structures. Here we conclude this session, but this doctrine, what it means is it means that where a rule has once become a settled law, it is to be followed. Although some inconvenience may grow from a strict observation of the same. Thanks.